Thank you, Graham. Now, after excellent presentation, my pre-speaker, I will bore academician. I apologize. And there are two words which probably you are not known to everybody. It's the environment. Environment, I organized in 2009 during Czech presidency the conference to the environment. And parallel, it was in Paris, the meeting committee of ministries, and they defined principle of e-democracy for e-environment. You see that it's a use of information communication technology for purpose of environment assessment and protection, spatial planning, and sustainable use of nature resources, including public participation. E-environment belongs to family E. It means e-participation, e-government, and we mean that it's one of the pillar of e-democracy. Well, but it's very short principle, and Committee of Ministers did explanation memorandum, and they defined other principles of e-democracy for e-environment. It's more understandable that the environment includes the use of ICT-based system for access and dissemination of environment data and information, and as well establishment IT-supported monitoring system of environment and repository to increase environment knowledge. It's not enough principles. Other principles is connected with the spatial planning. And at Europe, we've got Inspire directive for geospatial information, and it's also the pillar of the environment. And last principle is Aarhus Convention. Aarhus Convention is a basic motto of e-environment. It's access to environment information, public participation in decision making, and access to justice in environment matters. Oh. And I lost some slides, never mind. There was a picture of two things. One is how is this connected e-environment with single information space. We mean that single information space is following of single information space for environment is following of single information space as the part of Lisbon Convention. And now it's the part of e-European 2020 strategy and of course digital agenda for Europe. When we specify technically conceptual of the single information space for environment, named CISE, we have to consider in solving FP7 program, it's ICT Ensure project, that it's not only ICT infrastructure. We have to consider as a policy space, organizational space, and mostly legislation space, content, and technical space. There is a connection between e-environment and CISE. E-environment is connected with environment. It means that European 6 Environment Action Plan, Environment Policy Review, and now Digital Agenda for Europe. And it's supported by FP7 project, which I mentioned there. The newest is Future Internet. And there are plenty of conferences devoted to this topic. I mentioned Towards the Environment, which was organized in 2009 in Prague. Also, during Belgian presidency, it continued in a conference sharing environment information system, And at this conference is a new phenomena, new paradigma, it's open government data. I organize this June other conference divided to e-environment, frameworks, e-environment, where one section was devoted connection, open government data initiative, where Microsoft introduced Azure, and also there was presented open data initiative by Martin Kaltenburg from Austria. Digital agenda for Europe use the term e-environment enlarged as e-environment services. It belong to e-government services, but there are still under development, unsure and unfinished. And they are supported by law. It means law connected with Aarhus Convention and development of shared environment information system of European Union and INSPIRE directive. And in the plan is the review of directive on public access to environment information. We mentioned in morning session this direction and also public say administration, public approach to information which is connected in public administration. And also it's necessary support cross-border environment services, use interoperability, and member states could be stakeholder for implementation of cross-border environment services. And now there is big development of sensor networks. You know the initiative Global Monitoring Environment and Security System, Global Earth Observation System of System, which could be used, the Galileo and so on. And I summarize conclusion of our conference, which you can find at my speech at INSPIRE on, it's now at the YouTube, that there are, that it's necessary to establish national regional environment information web center for e-environment in member states. European data center for environment was established, and now I mention here also cloud computing. Microsoft developed for AirWatch and WaterWatch web page. It's I on Earth, where you can find for the whole Europe data, current data from the monitoring system about air pollution. And also this WaterWatch is the system which where you find the swimming pools and recognize if possible there are to go to swim or the water is polluted. It's necessary to educate also the skill or human capacity to use ICT tools and internet, which are developed through the single information space for environment, shared environment information system, global monitoring and security system, and GOSS. And Commission now try to develop institutional capacity. And for example, in our university, we prepare the special center for air pollution with heavy toxic materials, persistent organic pollutant. And it's necessary to ensure interoperability and develop and apply comprehensive environment-related ICT tools. I think that we don't have enough time, and I will give the floor to you.
Thank you very much.